第十七队演讲的题目是 Number Two， 计时开始。
Who has seen the wind? Neither I nor you. But when the leaves hang trembling, the wind is passing through. Christina Rossetti. Fair winds at your back will power you to where you want to be. Headwinds impede progress. Storms damage. Etiquette is the same. Etiquette is the set of social guidelines that give us a sense of fairness, but lightness and consideration for others. Travelers are constantly reminded to avoid causing events while overseas. International etiquette, or lack thereof, has particular consequences for young diplomats.
Respect. Mutual respect is a cornerstone of international etiquette. To earn respect, we must also give it. As we grow and move through society, we expand our relationships. As young diplomats, we will step out of our cultural comfort zone and act on our country's behalf. If we remain ignorant of the people and the places we visit, the odds of disrespecting our host and damaging our relationship is higher. For example, I went to Cambodia on my first international volunteer trip. The most memorable part of the trip was being invited into a local home. We respectfully greeted our host in local custom. But soon, after being seated, our host was staring at me, looking offended. I had carelessly left my feet exposed, a big cultural no-no, and considered very disrespectful. While this incident was minor, it was impressed upon me how a lack of proper respect could hinder or damage our new relationship.
Representation. We represent our school, our organization, perhaps our country, when we go abroad. In doing so, we must know that as our host sees us, he sees our country. We represent poorly when we lack manners and consideration of important customs. Hence the old saying, when you're wrong, do as the Romans do. I learned this in Fiji this past summer with YMCA. Church is a big part of the Fijian culture. It was suggested that we all wear Fiji's traditional dress, Nasulu, while attending church. However, some in our party thought not wearing Nasulu would be unimportant. They were very wrong. Although our host did not say anything directly, they were clearly offended, and we could all feel the damage this lack of consideration caused. Even though we had that many good things in the community, we are poor representatives at the moment, and it hurt our reputation. We never make this mistake a second time.
Reciprocity. We believe reciprocity is another important cornerstone of international etiquette. Reciprocity means giving back in the spirit with which something was received. This concept spans all human society. A simple example is the birthday gift. A gift received from my friend on my birthday is a warm gesture that shows I'm important to her. If I don't reciprocate on her birthday, what would it signal to my friend? Internationally, reciprocity means we care about the relationship with another society. Reciprocity is also about balance. We mustn't be too harsh on our judgments. In January, Texas Governor Greg Abbott gave President Tsai Ing-wen a clock. Clocks are inappropriate gifts in Taiwanese thinking, as they are traditionally associated with funerals and death. Some US media made a great deal over this story, yet President Tsai made light of this cultural faux pas. She understands the gesture was done with friendly intent. Is it realistic to expect our international counterparts to understand every nuance of Taiwanese beliefs? Reciprocity, at this level, is about showing we care, as well as finding the middle ground between two cultures.
Our three R's are key to why international etiquette is so important. Whether international or local, all social etiquette is about building and maintaining good relationships with other countries. Building a solid international relationship is like building a bridge. A bridge can take years to span a divide, but if built on a poor foundation or managed poorly, the whole thing can come crashing down. As overseas volunteers, young diplomats, or on business in the future, the stakes will be much higher. Respect, representation, and reciprocity. Proper attention to international etiquette is essential to our relationships with other countries. Who has seen the wind? Neither you nor I. But when the trees bow down their heads, the wind is passing by. Christina Rizzetti, who has seen the wind? Thank you.
第十四队演讲的题目是 Number 3, 计时开始。
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Taiwan, the heart of Asia, known as Formosa, named by the Portuguese for its stunning natural beauty. It is a beautiful island home to 23 million people and a new home to 500,000 immigrants. The island is famous for its delicious seafood, beautiful mountains, breathtaking scenery, and unique culture. It is a country that will leave a lasting impression on those who visit, and the experience is the one that cannot be found anywhere else. However, for a lot of travelers, Taiwan still seems to be an undiscovered travel destination. There is a myriad of activities and cultural experiences hidden in Taiwan, waiting to be discovered.
Thank you, Stella. So, what is there to do in Taiwan? When you arrive at Taiwan, you can take the high-speed rail to various locations around the country. It stops at many major cities, which saves you a lot of time on transportation. When you come to Taiwan, it's very important for you to try the street food. The best place for food lovers to taste what Taiwan has to offer is the local night market, which is where the East meets the West. You will be able to try so many different kinds of food. Whether you're a sushi lover, a burger addict, or you simply want some spicy Thai food, we have it all here. But don't forget to wash it down with the world-famous Taiwanese bubble milk tea, our most popular drink. It's a deliciously sweet tea made with milk and black pearls. And everyone who comes to Taiwan must try it. Vicky?
Thank you, Iris. If you want to see beautiful scenery and nature, Taidong is a great place to do just that. The famous Seashore Park is a park offering a gorgeous view over the ocean and also contains various artistic creations. You can ride bike, walk around, and chill out and enjoy the view. If the weather is right, you can even see Green Island, another famous destination from across the ocean. There are numerous beaches around the city. If you want to enjoy a nice sunny day at the beach, there are plenty of options in Taidong. Another very fun activity you can find in Taidong is the hot air balloon event in Luye Gaotai. You will have the opportunity to fly in the hot air balloon, which is an amazing experience. Floating high above the ground and watching the beautiful mountain scenery below you. It takes place for 1 month every year, usually around summertime. So, if you plan your trip right, you will have the opportunity to catch this incredible experience. Charlie?
Thank you, Vicky. Moving on to more urban life, Taipei, the capital of Taiwan, it's a city filled with diversity. You can find all types of cultures here, and it is most prominently found in food form. Taipei has restaurants and food stores everywhere. You can find all kinds of food from all over the world. And you can even taste the most delicious food in Taipei. Finally, one thing that is most important, Taipei 101. It's an incredible structure that towers over the whole city. You can even see from miles away. Only in person can one truly appreciate the magnificence of this building. There are tons of stores and restaurants in Taipei 101. And for a small fee, you can ride the high-speed elevator up to the highest floor of this building and gaze down the beautiful city. It is truly the most important attraction to visit when in Taiwan. The Shiling Night Market, one of the biggest night markets in the country, It's a perfect place to go to experience cultural diversity and taste delicious food. It's a must go for anyone who visits Taipei. Stella.
Thank you, Charlie. Taiwan is undoubtedly an amazing country, which, unfortunately, is still unknown to many people around the world. The amount of uniqueness and traditional culture, in addition to the beautiful nature this country has to offer, is just wondrous. It is a country that will open your eyes to the differences in the world and change your life. It is an experience that will create many stories for you to tell your friends, and an experience you will never forget. So start planning your next trip to visit us.
Thank you.
第12队演讲的题目是 Number 2, 计时开始.
Good morning. Keeping up with international etiquette is essential to success. Simply being aware and sensitive to the customs of other cultures can go a long way in making sure you don't make a major cultural faux pas. This can cost you and your company the lucrative business deal you so wanted to acquire. When living abroad, quite a few people inadvertently meet some social cues among their new colleagues, neighbors, or friends. They behave in what they think is a normal manner. And oops, suddenly, other people seem confused, irritated, or simply amused. You may not be able to explain what's wrong, or ask an even more difficult question why this type of behavior would be considered wrong in your host country. You did, however, notice that normal interaction and common sense failed you. Perhaps you may end up upsetting other people. Danny.
First of all, there is no such thing as a universally valid set of international etiquette rules, as every country in this world has its own unwritten code. Tiny mistakes in international etiquette can have a negative effect on your career, and most crucially, your reputation. They may be interpreted as a significant lack of manners and can put an abrupt end to your business abroad. And you might jeopardize your deal if you do not take the time to research social customs beforehand. Etiquette is no randomly assembled set of rules, but has its firm grounding to the cultures of respective countries. For example, if you are aware of the concept of face in Asian cultures, then you will know what implication it has. If you want to be respected by your Asian contacts, never lose face in front of them. And by all means, avoid causing your potential business partners to lose face. This is international etiquette. Can help your career.
Respecting other people's personal space is a crucial aspect of international etiquette. It is important to keep in mind that there are significant differences between cultures and between genders, although it is almost impossible to go wrong with the handshake. It's always a good idea to hold back when in doubt. By observing your environment closely, you'll learn quickly where people draw the line between cordiality and intrusiveness. You need to learn not to cross that line. You may notice that in some cultures, men are very touchy-feely with each other. Hugs may be a regular way of greeting partners and colleagues. However, for a man to greet a female colleague or contacts in the same way could be a huge faux pas. Vic.
In most Western countries, business cards serve a purely informational purpose. It is acceptable to bend them, fold them, shove them in your pocket, or use them to jot down some notes or a private phone number. However, in other parts of the world, international etiquette dictates that business cards must be treated utmost respect. In Arab and some Asian countries, it is important never to use your left hand to receive a business card, as this hand is reserved for personal hygiene. In other Asian countries, such as Taiwan, China, Japan, and Singapore, you give or receive a business card with both of your hands, often accompanied by a small bow. To conclude, we feel that international etiquette is a language. It's a language of respect, courtesy, and manners which crosses all borders and cultures. Chin Chin.
Having good manners and an understanding of international etiquette builds leadership, refines social skills, improves one's image, and increases self-confidence. These elements are fundamental to success. And it is in this simple test, which we can easily pick up, do we fully show off our true potential.
Thank you.
第11队演讲的题目是 Number 4, 计时开始。
Honorable judges, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Every time I look back at experiences I've acquired during junior high school and high school, for instance, the Model United Nations in which I participated many times, or even the international volunteer work I performed last summer vacation in Sri Lanka, I realized that they've all given me some essential abilities that young people need in today's international competitive society. Therefore, today my teammates and I are going to elaborate more on this topic. Nora, please proceed if you will.
Yes, James. International mobility encompasses a variety of population shifts and displacements, such as students' exchanges, skilled worker migration, so-called brain drains, and temporary international workers, to name a few. International moves can provide development opportunities, enhance corporate cultures, and allow the transfer of expertise and the sharing of knowledge between people from different countries. Therefore, as a Taiwanese teenager, enhancing our international mobility can not only broaden our horizons, but also develop our skills when dealing with international affairs. There are several methods one can employ to achieve this goal, and both official and non-governmental organizations can provide one with various avenues to succeed in this endeavor. Next, I would like to welcome my teammates, Donna and Charlotte, to introduce two successful examples of these groups, the Model United Nations and International Volunteering Organizations. Donna, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Nora. In terms of increasing abilities to handle international affairs, I think that participating in the Model United Nations is a great opportunity to help us achieve this goal. Participants serve as delegates to the United Nations, and they can act in the UN committees. They have to search for related information before conferences begin, and they will debate with other participants on behalf of other countries in the committee. A good example of this, which is worth introducing, is that National Taiwan University, which hosted the World Model United Nations Conference in 2010. More than 2,000 students from over 50 countries were recruited for this activity. It successfully allowed many Taiwanese students to become active internationally. Through this activity, we not only improved our public speaking, debating skills, and leadership abilities, but also increased our capabilities for handling international affairs. Charlotte, what do you think?
Thank you, Donna. However, the Model United Nations is not the only venue in which we can increase our international mobility. Participating in international volunteer programs is also an excellent choice for teenagers. Nowadays, countries all around the world desperately want to solve our global environmental problems. As an example, Hongqing has enjoyed amazing success with resource recycling in Romania. Because of him, the Wall Street Journal dubs Taiwan the home of the world's garbage disposal geniuses. As a teenager, the things we can do for our environment are not just about recycling or using the air conditioner less often. Being a volunteer to educate children in developing countries about environmental conservation is a way to protect the environment and make a difference in some of the regions of the world that need it the most. The old saying about giving someone a fish and feeding them for one day, teaching them to fish and feeding them for a lifetime applies here. Participating in international volunteer programs will not only promote our international mobility, but also contribute positively to international environmental affairs. James, where's your conclusion?
Thank you, teammates. Those examples you have introduced are indeed fascinating. In this modern era of globalization, enhancing our international mobility and the abilities in dealing with international affairs has become a crucial commodity. By participating in examples we have just mentioned, the Model United Nations and the International Volunteer Program, the twin goals of global vision and communication can both be cultivated. The young people of Taiwan are ready for the challenge. The world is spread out before us, waiting for us to step up and take the lead. Ladies and gentlemen,
thanks for your kind attention.
Number 3, 计时开始.
Thank you for giving us this opportunity to deliver this question. I dream of being a tour guide to introduce my hometown and my country to new visitors. Therefore, I've decided to work on my English. It's an essential skill as a southbound policy brings us closer to our Asian neighbors.
Taichung is not a mega city, so our visitors will have a chance to see the lives of average Taiwanese people. By taking the free bus and using e-bikes, our visitors will have a taste of local culture. They will see Taiwanese are civically minded. A trip to the Gaomei wetland shows Taiwan's commitment to innovation and progress in green energy. A tour of Da Jia Zhenlan Temple shows our guests how Taiwanese pray. Sadly, time won't be sufficient to show off all of the cultural landmarks. So we asked our visitors which sites interest them most.
The brand new National Theater, a beautiful new venue to appreciate music. The National Library, an excellent example of Taiwan's commitment to scholarship and beauty. The National Art Museum, which shows off local talent and creativity. Or the Science Museum, an incredibly fun place to learn and see Taiwanese family at leisure. A visit to Fengjia Night Market satisfies all tastes before we return to our hotel for a rest. The next day will be very eventful.
The next day after breakfast, we head to Taichung High Speed Rail Station. This is a perfect opportunity to invite our guests to visit our Taiwan's transportation system. As we zip along at nearly 300 kilometers per hour, the view of rich Taiwanese countryside and mountains just hint at the diversity of natural beauty in Taiwan. This is an excellent opportunity to invite our guests to visit again and detail some of treasures of Taiwan that they will be missing out on, like
Sun Moon Lake, the largest body of water in Taiwan, and home to one of the Aboriginal tribes in Taiwan. Taroko Gorge, the landmark gorge carved by the Liwei River. Kanding National Park, well known for its tropical climate, sunshine, scenic mountains, and beaches, or the beauty of Taiwan's island, such as Liuqiu Island.
We hop off the train in Hsinchu. Hsinchu is one of the fastest developing regions of Taiwan. We believe visitors will enjoy learning about the Silicon Valley by seeing the position of Taiwan's leading high-tech companies like TSMC and HTC. These companies power electronic products all over the world and provide a great look at Taiwanese innovation. After a quick tour,
we are back to the HSR to finish our trip north to Taipei.
We will arrive at Taipei 101, a true symbol of Taiwan. Our guests took one of the fastest elevators on Earth to take in the breathtaking view from the sky deck. Next, we finally get an opportunity to enjoy Taipei's MRT. The fast and convenient service makes everyone feel welcome as we go to Shili Night Market for a meal before a restful evening.
The next morning, before heading to Taoyuan International Airport to fly home, our visiting delegates stopped off at Gogoro headquarters, which is also in Taoyuan. This Taiwanese brand shows the creativity, passion for design, and desire to go green of Taiwan's youth. We hope our visitors agree that Taiwan has a lot of future potential for business and investment.
Finally, we will bring our honored guests to Taoyuan International Airport with plenty of time to spare. That's because the airport has consistently been rated as one of the best in the world for overall experience. It's also an excellent place to pick up the souvenirs for friends and family. I recommend Sunny Hills Pineapple Cakes and older visitor Gavin Lang Whiskey. These awarded brands demonstrate Taiwanese patience for food and drink. It's time to wish our new friend a fond farewell and safe trip. Without a doubt, they will be back to see more of this amazing island. This is the end of the speech. Thanks for your listening. Bow.
第七队演讲的题目是 Number One， 计时开始。
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. If you make a close observation of this beautiful island, you'll find that Taiwan has numerous standout qualities in plenty of ways. Geographically, Taiwan is located at an important strategic point.Which makes Taiwan act like a door to the Asia. Historically, Taiwan used to be a colony of different authorities and now displays diverse historical backgrounds to the world. Technologically, Taiwan's advanced technology industry is flourishing and affirmed in a wide range. With this standout qualities, Taiwan not only draws other countries' attention,but makes Taiwan competitive in economy and high-tech industry as well. More importantly, aside from location, history, and high-tech industry, Taiwan is worldwide famous for its friendly people living on the island. That is, Taiwanese are known as the friendliest people throughout the world.
Speaking of Taiwanese friendliness, many foreigners have the following experiences. We often hear that, when I was on the street and got confused by the map in my hand, Taiwanese would just come over and give me a hand. Or, I was really touched by Taiwanese hospitality, and therefore, I felt like traveling Taiwan again and again. According to the research conducted by International Expat Insider,2016 index, tourists will likely be welcomed with open arms in Taiwan, Uganda, and Costa Rica, which took the top three spots for the world's friendliest countries. And some 90% of expats in Taiwan gave local residents high marks for hospitality. And more than 90%, or even more than one-third of expats in Taiwan even considered staying on this tiny Pacific island forever. In other words, it is Taiwanese friendliness that successfully attracts visitors.
What's more, Taiwanese people not only treat foreign travelers with a kind heart, but also act generously to other countries in need. One of the instances is that,When the fierce earthquake struck Japan in 2011, Taiwanese donated over 2 billion Japanese yen to the country, which was the highest sum in record among all the helping countries. In addition to raising funds, rescue team and some charities provide the country in need with donations and humanitarian aid. When it comes to reaching our helping hand to the needy country, Taiwan, as a global villager, has never hesitated. Meanwhile, Taiwan and its diplomatic friends often work together to enhance their agricultural skills, medical treatment, and technological developments.
Taiwan's standout quality, in our opinion, is Taiwanese friendliness and hospitality. This is a remarkable quality we have to demonstrate to the globe. Though Taiwan is a tiny island, the image of being friendly and warm-hearted has been rooted in the hearts of people around the world. This is our power, which is directly from every individual in Taiwan. Displaying this soul power toward the world will gain popularity and play a more and more crucial part in this vastly changing world. 5,000 years ago, Taiwan is called Formosa, a beautiful land. Now, in my heart, it is people that make the most beautiful scenery on this island. And with this standout quality, we surely show a different Taiwan to the world.
Number 2, 计时开始.
Good morning to everyone in attendance here. My teammates and I would like to introduce our views as to why we believe international etiquette plays a valuable role in establishing healthy relations between nations of the world. As young global citizens, we are aware of the universe that exists outside of Taiwan and respect the differences that exist amongst countries. So, I ask you, whilst traveling, have you ever said or done anything that could be perceived as a personal slight toward those in their home country? If so, this may have happened because you were not aware that what you were doing or saying was inconsiderate. Being aware of your host nation's social etiquette is essential because there are no second chances to offer first impression. Now, Tong Tong will offer some further thoughts.
Thank you, JJ. When discussing the importance of etiquette, people often mention the need to respect other cultures. This may be the primary reason for knowing and understanding that etiquette displayed globally is essential. If you show respect for other cultures, then you are taking responsibility in making sure that you don't offend anyone while being a visitor in their home. This will no doubt make your stay aboard much more enjoyable. Take France, for example, where it is not proper to split the bill after a meal with friends, as this is seen as unsophisticated. In particular parts of the world, even certain body languages, such as keeping your hands in your pocket, can be seen as acting unfriendly. Therefore, as global ambassadors meeting many different people, it is always valuable to know what is considered to be impolite behavior. Here, Teresa will continue with our speech.
Thank you, Tang Tang. Many of you may now be thinking that since we have discussed the need to show respect, what more could there be? Well, I would like to add that a clear comprehension of international etiquette can also aid in a better understanding of the world. Respecting other cultures can provide you with knowledge which you may not otherwise come across or be aware of. It can offer you a wider view of the world and a deeper respect of the other cultures. Let's look at Singapore, for example. When one is offered a gift there, it is polite to refuse the offering three times. This shows that the recipient of the gift is not greedy. Being aware of customs such as this can help prevent a situation from becoming both awkward and confusing. It can also help you feel more confident when approaching people while abroad. Finally, Maggie will offer our concluding thoughts.
Thank you, Teresa. As students of today, some of us plan to become future entrepreneurs of the world. For us, international etiquette is extremely important, given that roughly 64% of Taiwan's business is conducted internationally. An example of Japanese business etiquette that we should be aware of is that it is not polite to accept one's business card and simply put it into your pocket. Rather, the polite response is to receive it with two hands, slightly bow, and look at it carefully to show respect before putting it away. We trust that you'll take some time to research international etiquette prior to your future travels, whether it is for business, education, or pleasure. Being knowledgeable and understanding of other cultures and their etiquette norms they follow will not only keep you from disrespecting others, but it will also open up your view of the world.
Thank you for your attention.
第四队演讲的题目是 Number One， 计时开始。
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's an honor and pleasure to give a speech in front of you. Taiwan is known as a marvelous place with lively mountains and rivers. Since the age of discovery, the Portuguese has been calling us Formosa, meaning the beautiful island. Although we are a small country, we do have a lot to show. When it comes to scenery, Taiwan is special for its landscapes. Because of the plate movements, there are a lot of high mountains in Taiwan, from Xueshan Mountain, Yushan Mountain, to the Central Mountains. In fact, there are more than 100 mountains that are above 3,000 meters high on this small island. The mountains alone present a tremendous view. Thus, some people come all the way to Taiwan to hike and enjoy the beautiful scenery. With trees that are evergreen, clouds that are below our feet at the mountaintop, and the magnificent scenery along the way, this is where one would never forget. Now, I would like to leave the next part to my teammate, Winnie.
Thank you,
Judy.
If you are a sport enthusiast who would like to challenge yourself, you might even consider cycling around Taiwan on a bike. What better view can you get with the breeze of wind by your side? And not to mention the advantage, the flexibility of bikes. Exploring Taiwan counterclockwise on bikes is the best route to get an overall view of the mountains, the rivers, and the sea. The west coast is mostly lined up with big cities. However, once you travel southward, the route gradually became fields and orchards. The magnificent view of both the mountains and the rivers in our east coast is definitely worth your time, though the route might be a little challenging. In addition, you can also go to a hot spring, which is really refreshing and relaxing. Now, I'd like to leave the next part to my teammate, Jessica.
Thank you, Winnie. What's more, each city has its specialty. Rice noodles in Hsinchu, sun cakes in Taizhou, bawan in Zhanghua, coffee in Ning, turkey rice in Jiayi, and so forth. Besides these dishes, there are also traditional Taiwanese snacks and a variety of fruits every season. Chinese omelets, pork steamed buns, rice balls alone with soybean milk or black tea for breakfast, bento, rice porridge, beef noodles for lunch, shaved ice to boost your spirit at dessert in the afternoon, and something good for dinner. So, there's one thing for sure. Wherever you go, there will be delicious foods all along. In addition to the outstanding view and the unforgettable cuisine, Taiwan is also known for its convenience. For some people, there is no place like home. For most, there are no places like convenience stores in Taiwan. The convenience stores in Taiwan are open 24/7. From the hustle and bustle downtown to the most remote areas, we can see familiar signs of convenience stores all along the road. You can get almost everything you need in these stores. Other than snacks, you can also find a variety of daily necessities, such as tissues, cheap raincoats, and sunscreens to meet your needs. Now, I would like to leave the next part to my teammate, Lisa.
Thank you, Jessica. What's more, there is also an area in some of the convenience stores for people to sit down, take their breath, and rest. So when you ride past a convenience store on the side of the road, do get off your bike, hop in and relax a bit. Above all, although many would praise the unforgettable scenery of Taiwan, one of the most unforgettable features that Taiwan possesses is actually people. People in Taiwan are kind, warm, and hospitable. So if you need anything during the trip, don't be afraid to ask for help. Arrange a vacation to Taiwan today. You may fall in love with this beautiful island and eventually decide to stay here. All this 1 hour speech here.
Thank you.
第三队演讲的题目是 Number Two， 计时开始。
The world is constituted of diverse cultures. As we go abroad, there are chances that we face problems out of ignorance of the local customs and norms. This may lead to misconception or even great conflicts with foreigners. Thus, adopting international etiquette would be an effective way to avoid these kinds of problems. With the conventional manners, we can efficiently achieve the targets of trade, communication, or cultural exchange with people from different countries. That is, international etiquette can be used as the best tool to bridge the gap between nations. What's more, it is also essential to recognize the common types of etiquette to make sure we can behave properly under different circumstances. Next, Jason is going to tell us some basic etiquette in our daily life.
Thank you, Sophia. Yes, international etiquette plays such an important role when it comes to global communication. Therefore, we should get to the details of protocols in various forms. In this way, we can truly understand their influence on various spheres. The first one is everyday etiquette. The seats we take in the car, or the priority to take an escalator, should be based on age, gender, or the hierarchy of guests. The important guest must take a right rear seat when it's a driver, and he or she should take a right front seat when it's a host who drives the car. Ignoring a rule will not only let others think we're impolite, but also lead to the terrible impression on our country. Since every citizen might be the representative of a nation and influence at any time, without handling it well, we may even ruin the chances of building amicable relationship with important guests at formal events. Thus, other than the auto and stairs etiquette, Vivian is going to further elaborate on dining manners and attire forms.
Thank you, Jason. Indeed, we should focus on everyday etiquette, for it has the broadest impact on every person's overseas experiences. Dining, for example, when attending a formal banquet, what you wear is very important. Black ties, evening gowns, and national clothes would be the most proper choices. In addition, when it comes to table manners, we should be aware of the normal practice when using utensils. For instance, remember to use forks and knives from outside in. Glasses with don't stand should be held by the stems and never make sound when eating or drinking. If you are invited to a church buffet party, always tip 10% of the meal, no
matter what. With the proper international manners, we show respect to the occasion and the people attending it, by which we will gain respect from them too. Hence, we can say it is a powerful means to do citizen diplomacy. And thus, Michael will talk about the importance of social presence on business.
Thank you, Vivian. After dwelling on the daily courtesy, business etiquette is another big topic to focus on. Applying great protocols would enhance the relationship among companies and make business trades more easily to achieve. Besides, etiquette of employers will represent the images of their companies. So when we have to meet a foreign customer or business partner, make sure to follow the international conventions. Be dressed in black suits. Wait for the person with higher status to offer a handshake first. And use our both hands to give the business card with the words facing the recipient. To sum up, international etiquette can be practiced in daily life and on official occasions, like business or academic events. Bearing basic manners in mind will not only help us make efficient communication with others, but also leave others an excellent impression on ourselves and where we are from. So, to be a qualified global citizen, let us start from learning international etiquette.